Hi, I'm Johnny Stan, president of Stan Manufacturing, Fort Pierce, Florida. I'm here today to make a video of operation of our signal leader SLT-2112. S is for the scissor lift, and the L is the lift part, and the T is for traversal. So now you have the nomenclature 12 feet. It goes 12 foot that way to the right. And then this one is a special unit that actually comes another 4 feet to the left. That is an option that's not for standard. Our standard SLT-2112 was 12 foot only to the right. What I'm going to do right now is we're going to cut the tape and I'm going to set up inside and we'll give you an operation. Thank you. We have two buttons inside. One is the master switch and the other one is the PTO. When I engage the PTO, you'll hear the engine RPM come up to the operating standard pressure of 1100 approximately, so that we can operate all the hydraulics. So I'm going to start it and we'll do it through the process right now. And it will be in neutral. I just pushed the master switch. That allows everything electronically to operate. This is a storage cabinet for signs. Store what you need in here. I don't have to explain that to any of y'all because you already know what it is. Get that out of the way. Next step we're going to do is your travel lock. When you get out of the truck, go onto it, set it down. The next stage we're going to is we're going to lower the outriggers. We're going to go to the other side. First of all, let me give you some stuff here. We will come back to these controls after we lower the outriggers. The outriggers must be lowered before anything will work. We have a safety interlock. Unless the truck is stable, leveled off, you're not going to have any operation. All right, these are your controls. We're going to open them up. You're going to understand everything we're doing. You'll see outriggers, crane. At this time, we're only interested in the outriggers. This is a stop. This shuts off power if something went wrong. These are a little noisy because we put extra seals in these, tighten them up. We have extra seals put in these outriggers because we've had a problem in the north with excessive slushy salt and snow getting on them, so you get a better wiper system. After you use it a few times, the noise will go away. We ask that you load the truck onto the outriggers because that will activate the control switches to activate the lift, because if you don't get into these and get the bypass clearance, we're lowered on the other side. You'll notice I leveled the truck. And the purpose of that is so that you get your interlock system in play. Our interlock system is in play. We'll come back to these outriggers, these controls, and they will control the crane. This particular unit has a crane. So we'll come back to that in a little bit. We're going to go around to the other side, and we're going to operate the lift, because this is the primary part of this, is the operation of the SLT-2112. Okay, while we're operating here, this is a valve. We're changing it over to operate this. When I pull it out, it operates the outrigger. So at this moment, we're going to operate the lift. So we change. Now the outriggers cannot be touched or tampered with. They're stationary and that's it. I'm going to turn around over here. This is the platform. Those controls are very self-explanatory. These are the valves. There they are. This right here is for the upper controller. up there, lower control, and down here. There's another control button in here that operates as I push benches. This unit also goes to the left side of the truck. Under normal circumstances, we do not make a lift that goes to the left side of the truck. Here's the control button here that will operate it to the left. Other than that, this button will never be there. You operate up and down, in and out, only to the right. There's the lift going up. Lift going down. Is our standard position. This is the optimal position. This is not a standard unit. Other than that, that lower unit goes all the way to the other side and extends out 12 feet. Turn everything off. This is an emergency stop. Bam. Hydraulics are off. Back on. This is an E-pump. Make the hump, and that's in case you lost engine power. Now we're going to go around and we're going to get one of our associates, Mike Newsom, who also, if you have a problem and you call the factory, you'll be able to talk to John Stamp, Mike Newsom, primarily Mike Newsom, because he's on the phone here and stuff like that. So he's going to climb up and go through the operation up top. And Mike is going to get up in the tower at this moment and prepare himself. Put this over the upper control. Okay, we got Mike on the platform. He's raising himself up. That's going about 3 to 5 feet so he's in a feel for it. He's now going to reverse the upper platform first. This platform is the first phase. Now the next platform is going to come out of stage two, or the lower stage. That stage will come out. Now he's switching a button over to operate the lower stage, only because it goes the other way. If it did go the other way, he wouldn't be switching those switches. It'd be going straight out and back. That right there is your 2112 at the creature down. Now he's going to put it back. Put the upper stage. Lower stage. This is only because this truck was ordered with left side conversion. We've got about 75 or 80 units moving already. This is number two that goes the other way. So it's very, very rare. You have to line yourself up. Be visual. Go the other way a little bit. You're going to go to the other side. There's his traversing to this side. The platform, aluminum, does not go anywhere. It stays, it's a single suspension to the right of the truck. We'll raise you up at this moment. Run all the way up. Oh, excuse me, we're talking about that right now while he did it. We have engine shut off up there. All controls up there match what they have down there. If you lose everything, you have an E-pump. Hear that E-pump running at this moment, and it will bring the unit back to normal so you can leave with the truck. speed comes back up, everything normal when you shut it off or whatever. So when you're working with it, you'll have full access. As this is going up, you notice a lot of places to lock off. Move yourself around on the plane. This is a unit that can work on street signs, traffic lights, and signs on the road to the right or the left. This gives you the movement to work on street signs. Now you see, go all the way over. We might be able to get a good shot of this. Alright, there you have your working area. So you have your 12 foot all the way out. Now we're going to stow it away. Recommend that, you know, you get the feeling of the control valve, the feathering valve. So the feathering valve assists you in speed control. Now he's putting away what we call the lower. Now you have to line that up with your manual. You'll see right now he went too far. So he's going to back up and then straighten himself up so it stows away perfectly. That's the only time you have to do that is when you have a left side. This truck here is equipped with a crane. We're into the next phase of this piece of equipment. That's the crane. This crane right here is full hydraulic. This is the instructions right here. You must have the outriggers out to operate it. As a matter of fact, for the crane to operate, you have to be on the outrigger control. So if you change over to lift, make sure you change back to the outrigger control. Operate this, now you're operating the crane. I'm going to actually lift the crane out of the saddle. Oh, one more lift. We have hand control that we need to discuss. This is a hand control. This right here is what plugs in. I'm going to do all that. We'll store this right here. You have a 1,500 pound capacity. So pull poles, hold other tools. Well, this is a 1,500 pounds. Now we'll just stow it away because there's not much more that I need to talk about this way. Other all the controls are right here. I'm a little jumpy. You see where to stow it inside, it's very visible. In fact, the man who put this together, Dale in the shop, informed me that he made that just high enough so I could stand on my toes and see it. Good the first time. We're gonna put this away. That's the crane. We don't need to discuss anything more about that. We actually will undo this, pull this out, put it all together. Gather it all up and stow it away. How you operate the crane on the outrigger. This vehicle has tons of lights. What we're going to do is we're going to turn all the lights on and let our cameraman here just walk around holding the camera so he can just get a visual of some of the lights. Not everybody gets all these lights. All right, you'll see all the lights working then. This, like I told you earlier, this truck has tons of lights. You can see this thing miles away. You'll notice the side lights, the rear lights. You'll notice the traffic advisor. That could go left or right, which everybody knows. Let me stop one second and show you this. You want to put something in the back of here? Come over here, pick up this right here, and you can swing it out of the way so you can actually use the back of the truck loading or unloading. Come back. Lock it back. You need to take it off, repair. It unplugs here. Other than that, that's pretty simple. So it has great photo shoots, just lights. Just give you an idea about lights. Lights, bells, and whistles will always be something that you want to tell us what you want. I don't know how I can explain anything more. What you've just visually seen here is an instructional statement. This instructional statement will help you upgrade an SLT. And if you order one to the left, this should also work for the dual purpose. But we primarily do 98% only go to the one side, and that would be the right side to service signs, etc. This is Johnny Stamm. And I want to thank you for taking the time to video, view our video. Everybody gets that momentarily. But anyhow, about this, any questions, please feel free to call us. Any literature you might want, call our office. We have, there's Glenn Bennett. There's Chris Dillon in sales that will help you. We will give you a set of specs for anything you want. We'll also help you write your own specs. And as far as the lights, a lot of you guys already know what you want for lights or an idea of what you got. We'll be happy to work with that. Bells and whistles are your port, manufactured with the SLT 2112 is our port, and let's put them together.